There was a campaign for the impending arts cut funding, and there was kind of meetings and talks about marches and stuff like that, and I felt it would be better for the arts community to do something creative rather than walk down with placards and stuff like that. So, you know, the flash mob thing, obviously it happens worldwide, and it's got huge effect and impact, and wanted to find a really good song, uplifting song, which is Mr. Blue Sky, and I was trying to get something that would cheer people up rather than remind them about we've no money.
Where did we go wrong? Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong?
My name is Owen O'Hanlon Cohen, and I am involved in Cork's branch of the National Campaign for the Arts. So basically, the National Campaign for the Arts is trying to stop the government from cutting the funding for the arts, and also to keep a department for the arts, to keep our representation at ministerial level.
Welcome to the human race, a celebration. Mr. Blue Sky's up there waiting, and today is the day we've waited for. Ah. Oh, Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong?
We wanted to make sure that the scale of it then stayed on a large scale, and to be ambitious with it in terms of to take over Patrick Street rather than it to be in Dawn Square like we're doing.
Of people, and I'm delighted to have done it and to share the joy of dance and movement and music with everybody.
Off with kind of a pressing down like that, and then what happens is you kind of begin to creep a bit and creeping, and then you start going higher and higher and higher and higher and higher. we had a look at the CIUs.
Well, there was a meeting in the Everyman about the campaign, the national campaign for the arts, and there was talk about lobbying politicians and stuff like this, and I suppose it was my idea to do this, a flash mob. But once I mentioned it, Cormac O'Connor, a sound designer, composer, got involved, graffiti got involved, Kat from the Granary, we got Tina Horn, who's the choreographer, who we asked her to do it, and she's just been brilliant because she... how she can communicate, and she has come up with the choreography for it in a way that's going to be relatively easy to remember for a cross section of people who've never danced, to people who do dance, but also that they but that it's something that they can enjoy, you know, quickly, because we made the choice of just there will be tonight and Saturday morning, and then we go out in the street to do it.
Three, go again, now one, two, three.
I've worked with in dance and movement for years and years, and I love people, and I love music, and I love dance, and I believe in the power of it, and the joy it brings, and the way it lights people up.
It shows, even in the numbers tonight, then, what goodwill there is towards the arts in a much more positive way than cribbing about the money. And what was interesting as well is that because it's been, a lot of arts organisations have come together to make this happen. Everybody is doing it free of charge. And, you know, when we came in tonight, we were kind of like, we kind of really ambitious, it would be great if we got 500 people. There's going to be more people on Saturday. I think it's around 400 tonight, which is just extraordinary. We weren't expecting that, and I think the big thing really is that people are having such fun. I was having great fun, and the participants are having great fun. So I think it's going to be, for whatever reason, I don't mind. But it's just great. It was a buzz tonight now, and hopefully that'll transmit itself to the city centre now on Saturday.
You hear the music, you know the song, but you're all off flying here.
Of it in terms of how we're going to get in and get out, okay? Why we're in eight groups, okay, is that from Winthrop Street to Academy Street, there are eight points of entrance, okay? So that's the area in which we're looking at performing, okay? Now, the basic idea of it is that because we're all in just or ordinary everyday clothes, okay, is that in the general public who are out on Patrick Street doing their shopping, going into the market for a chicken or whatever, right, okay, that they don't know what's happening, okay? So there will be a sense of a build in the piece, okay, where there'll be more people joining it there'll be three times, okay, three different sections. So each number, if you're a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
my name is Martin Condon, and I'm here in Cork City supporting the arts. Flash mob was organised, and I heard the call and I came to lend my support.
I was contacted by Cork Docker about it and asked would I be interested in doing it and lending my support to it.
On the internet, the big secret was put out there. Call to arms, as it were, and we came, we danced, and we had some fun.
They assigned two young women to me to teach me the dance, which was quite fun, without being sleazy. And painstakingly, they went through the dance with me, and we got there eventually. And I also did my own valid interpretation of it.
I think I'm going to be up in Penny's window looking out or something like that. or else I might be down amidst the crowd just being there, checking it out.
tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Why did we go wrong? Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Why did we go wrong? Hey, you with the pretty face, welcome to the human race. A celebration. The blue sky is up there waiting, and today is the day we've waited for. Ah. Oh, Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue, it's a place to be with you. Look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you.
Today we had a flash mob on Patrick Street in Cork, which was a great success, great fun altogether. And it's just kind of to remind people of how much fun the arts can be, make people smile, and then just to raise a bit of awareness and hopefully get people to sign the petition on ncfa.ie.
A lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. We rehearsed Wednesday night at a secret location, got the dance moves down. We met again this morning for those people that didn't get the dance moves done, myself, and we came out and at 1:30 sharp we took over the streets of Cork, letting Mr. Blue Sky in.